to Ghana. Last year, I talked about how 150 people were killed as a result of flooding and an explosion at a gas station. This year, about 10 people have died because of heavy rainfalls that lasted for days. Some of them died when a building collapsed on them, and then some of them were electrocuted. Some were just carried away by the flood. I saw videos of streets washed away, and I was like, what?
FBE on the beat. Yeah. So we end this at Suwana heading. Oh, on your dog. Abba, go.
Mommy, focus, focus. See, I would turn, I would don't your logos.
Yeah, it's really bad. It's really bad. And not enough media coverage. I don't know why. By the way, did you guys notice trash floating on the streets? And this is not peculiar to Ghana. The same thing is happening in different parts of Nigeria. In Abakiliki, crops and properties worth millions of naira were destroyed in Ebonyi State. About 5,000 people are now homeless because of the flood. And in Lagos, especially Egbeda, Ikoton, and Ipaja, it's been a mess. For those who lost their loved ones in the flood in Ghana, in Nigeria, may their souls rest in peace. But what I don't understand is why some of my brothers and sisters in Ghana went online saying that Accra is not the only city flooding. They're saying that Paris is also flooding, Paris, London. I said, hey, look at these people. How are these people thinking? I was trying to understand how these people think. And then I saw this article by Chris Vincent. And I said, my brother, you said it all. It's true that floods can happen anyway. But when your own city is flooding every year, every single year, and you don't put up necessary measures to prevent it, that is what they call stupidity. These places that you're comparing yourself with, Paris, they flood periodically, not every single year. Number two, London, Paris, Texas, the kind of disaster relief response that they have, we don't have it in Nigeria, they don't have it in Ghana. So people don't have to suffer as much in those places like we do in Africa. They have helicopters airlifting people, they have ambulances waiting to take them to the hospital. So please stop comparing Ghana's flood to the one happening in Texas. Lastly, these people in these other countries, they have insurance. They have insurance. When they lose properties in the flood, insurance companies will pay them for their loss. They can get a new car, they can get a new house. How many Ghanaians have their properties insured? How many Ghanaians will get a new house after this flood? How many Nigerians will get a new house after this flood? I think that we should focus on how to prevent the flood in our own countries instead of justifying it by comparing ourselves to Texas or Paris. If we don't, I hate to say this, but seriously, if we don't be surprised that the same thing may happen again next year. But you guys now don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real.